Marching band is a big entire family. That's something you can never separate. That's, you gotta love them.
I would say band camp memories with the drumline and also our rehearsals inside. They were very focused, but yet they were still fun.
It's just something about doing it over and over again, accomplishing like a little bit, doing something a little bit better than you did the last rep makes you feel good.
I'd say the freshman camp was really fun. We got to meet all the new freshmen and we got to start drumming. Good experience.
I would have to say either performing at Centennial for Music in Motion or Stockdale Spectacular, the very last show, because both shows we put an incredible product at the field, and it felt really great listening to everybody just play together and have it all look like what we had envisioned from the very beginning. So performing those two shows were the highlights of the season for me.
Oh gosh, there's a lot actually. I guess I could say like just being with the battery, you know, just practicing every single day, just being with them like every single day. We get like a new feeling like every day. We just feel like we're getting better, like not only as drummers but just as people, and we get closer as a family.
My favorite memory would have to be senior night, the football game. Even though we all thought that it would be our last football game, it wasn't. And I just had a great time that night. I think performed really well, and it was really emotional.
What is your favorite memory from this marching? What?
It was at Centennial. I was giving a speech, and South High's band so kindly did background music for my speech.
Hey, focus on your horn angles. But if you are giving every ounce of effort to this show, make yourselves proud tonight.
They were playing, it was a tribute to Queen.
To this program, to you.
And it fit with it as well, so it was kind of neat getting to experience that myself.
I always loved the Veterans Day Parade. I know that everyone doesn't like it because it's just so grueling being out there and having to march, but I love it. I love it every single year because I just feel like I've honored veterans.
My favorite memory is like when Green got pied.
Come on, Carlos!
Louise! Everyone was just like so excited. The pep band song, it just made everything much even better. It was just an amazing experience because, like, finally we get to pipe Mr. Green and raise that much money to do.
My favorite
favorite memory would have to be the award ceremony at Centennial. Because we really had no clue what was going on. We didn't know what we were going to get, and then we ended up getting such a high score.
I'm happy to announce this trophy goes to Independence High School.
Sweepstakes in a lot of categories.
Well, when we're walking back from awards block with all the trophies and seeing everyone how excited they are. We know that our work's paid off.
Exhausting. I'm kidding. No.
Fantastic.
He's not kidding.
I'm not kidding. But it's fun.
Progressive.
No. It's a season.
Pretty good. I'll say stressful.
Lit.
That's too rewarding.
Got it. Pinta. Oh my god. Fun. I think fun is a pretty good one.
I forgot one. Fun.
Really fun.
Adventures. We had a lot of adventures.
Progressive.
Yep.
Intense. Yeah.
That's the way to describe the word.
Experience. Basically.
Something.
Sparkly.
Lots of
fun.
Intense.
It's been a journey.
Gains.
Gains.
Yeah,
that's
exciting.
Yeah, roller coaster.
Amazing.
Busy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So busy.
Good. Wow. Phenomenal.
Glittery.
Perfect.
Yes.
Sparkle.
It was glittery.
Sparkle.
Too much glitter.
I have a spiritual experience.
A spiritual experience.
That's two words.
It's touched my soul.
It's not. No, that's
three words. Three words.
Definitely this past year, OBE was like the best show I've like ever been a part of. It was so fun.
It was something I've never even had an association with my instrument being baritone and cymbals. Maybe they're both the same color, that's it.
What I like most is just in the moment of right before we perform, once we're all set up, while they're introducing us, and just during the show, while everything's going right and stuff, and just hearing it all come together and what we worked for.
I knew a mightier world, varied world, fresh.
My favorite event this year, it has to be our Drumline's Pack Finals run.
Pack Finals.
Come, my tan-faced children, all well and honored.
Because, it was our best performance yet.
Because that was the best run of anything we've ever done as Independence High School.
Is the feeling of having no regrets after a performance, just best feeling I ever had this season.
Pack Finals, we left everything on the floor. We had no regrets about anything.
It was clean, it had so much emotion to it, and it just proved our point of us being one of the best drum lines in Bakersfield.
That's what I love about Independence. I came here because these people are serious about drum. Not any other drum line can, you know, be rank number two in pack lines.
Come, my
pan-faced
children.
Schumacher, and I was in color guard this year for field season and winter. It was a really cool experience. I met a lot of people. I gained a lot of friendships that hopefully will last a long time, and they're amazing people.
Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm Christiana Martinez, and I was on varsity color for 4 years, and I helped coach JV this year.
Performing their show, A Night in Paris.
Color guard was just something that I could do and be happy with how I looked and stuff.
It was a good experience. It helped me learn a lot of patience. I also made friends on that team too, so that's fun. Out of town was really fun, like going to Union City and hanging out in the hotel and the pool and everything.
I always like finals because it's always like just a rush of emotions and you never know what's going to happen or how it go, and it's just like getting that to have that experience with the team, it's great.
The friendships I built over time and the strong bond of a team to come together and to be what we are today from 4 years ago is such an amazing journey. Like to see how much we have grown and changed in our program to be successful as we are today.
We actually have one of the largest color guards in Bakersfield, so we have 17 in our varsity and 18 in our JV. And you look at those numbers and that's huge. So to see those two extremes, we weren't sure if separating that many freshmen into a JV program was how that was gonna go, but they pulled through great. Varsity came out, just it's a beautiful product. It's probably my favorite one we've ever done. I tell them all the time, and you can ask all of them, and I repeat it over and over, what I want from you is to be a stronger, more confident, more able person in life at the end of your career as when you started it. That's our goal, is for you to be a more grown up, mature version of yourself with a little bit of us, you know, stuck in there. That's what we really want, is them to mature into a person that can go out into the world and be successful. And that's what we hope we get from them. It's a big group. They really do embody that. Like that's, we've given them that ability to go out and stand strong and be them, be themselves, but know that they're stronger than when they started.
I'm a major of tennis too. So that's pretty cool. She's tennis drum major now. Hey, Captain Kirk or Captain Picard, which one's better? Discuss.
He's gonna break my
I take full responsibility for my section.
Tell me everything I know except for that. No.
The card's way better, by the way.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone.
I will teach my children.
Oh hey, that prop is leaving. I'm gonna run for it. No! Son of a biscuit! Watch out, it's blowing! Hey, we can sell boats with these! You want to comment on the rogue props?
There was no rogue props. It was a secret Jedi. It was me.
Okay.
I can't never.
They
literally.
Yeah,
put it over the.
Where is this?
Oh,
God.
Oh, you have to shoot.
Is this gonna be, you know, how my interview goes?
Ah!
Whoopity scoop. I think we can all agree. Whoopity scoop.
Is that our best moment?
That's our best moment.
Whoopity scoop, scoopity poop.
Always have fun.
Anybody's better than Jerry.
I have a secret confession to the camera, but Courtney Olsen can never see it. I'm meeting Courtney Olsen in words with friends right now, because I downloaded a cheat app, and it's totally playing like these crazy words that I have no idea what they mean, but they count. And she's really mad at me right now, because she's like, where are you coming up with these words? And it's because I'm cheating. But she can never, ever, ever see this video. Listen to the end of the season.
Mr. Green, stop stressing. Just relax and have fun, because it's a really enjoyable experience.
I just want to say thank you to everyone that helped me along the way, and I want to give a special shout out to Mr. Green for always pushing me to be the best that I can be.
Thank you so much. It was an amazing season, and it was just a fun time. Thank you.
Continue to strive for excellence, and like we've always have, and yeah, never let up. Make it happen.
I'd like to thank Matt, the drum tech, the drum instructor, for vouching for me when I wanted to come back to band, even though Green probably didn't want to let me come back.
Shout out to my puppies, Daisy and Teddy. Love you.
Thank you for this fun experience. I love you all.
I'm just really grateful for everyone. My baritone family, Richie, who calls me traitor, my flute section, and Megan, who was really proud of everything that I've done, my bass section with Taylor.
All the staff,
And to Mr. Green, thank you for everything. You guys put a lot of work in, helping us become the best musicians, the best performers, the best people that we can be, and you guys pour yourselves into everything you do for us. Deep down, we all appreciate you and everything that you do for us, so thank you.
I want to thank Liz and Being Green for shaping me into the person I am today. I'm very dedicated to what I love.
I just want to thank them for like making these 4 years amazing, and to all the friends I've made and friends I've lost touch with. Like, I'm still thankful for all those memories that we've had together.
Mr. Green, I appreciate everything you did, because even though this is my first year, I feel like I have more of a bond, especially with something I'm not accustomed to, so I appreciate that.
For Matt, Adam, and Fern, you guys put together such an amazing program. Hope that we can carry that on for the next 3 years that I'm here, so thank you guys.
Thank you for the staff and even the students for helping me during my freshman year, because I learned a lot this year.
Students, never stop trying. Always do your best, perform, just feel the emotion.
Seniors, it's been a great 4 years, and thank you for the experiences.
Thank you for everything that you've allowed us to do, all the hard work that you have put in.
I would like to thank Green and all the boosters for making everything possible.
We love you, Liz!
She's pretty great.
She's awesome.
Best. Best there ever was. Best. I'd be screwed without Elizabeth Dierzo.
Thank you.
Well, through a band, I met a lot of good people. They became my closest friends, and I really love playing music throughout my 4 years of high school, especially.
I think being in band in high school has kind of helped like in all areas. I mean, I've grown musically, I've met a lot of people, I've built a lot of like leadership and skills, collaboration kind of skills, so just generally it's helped me pretty much in everything.
When I started high school, I thought that it would be a lot of fun, but it would also just be a challenge, which it was, and I'm super glad that I joined.
Funny story, actually, I was going to quit band before I came to high school, but I think what was most memorable and what actually made me want to stay in marching band was when Mr. Green asked me to play the oboe, and after that I started getting more into band, and yeah, so here I am now.
I'd done guard in junior high, but it wasn't anything like high school, and like I was just so amazed about like the dancing and like the like ability to show what you feel under an equipment. It's just unexplainable.
When I started high school, I thought it was really fun, and I saw all the pretty colors in the field. I was like, oh, I want to do that. So I did, and it was fun.
I'll always remember leaving the football field every practice exhausted, but you know, fulfilled and proud.
I will always remember the people that I met in band, and also just having an enjoyable time with all the instruments that I played.
My favorite field show? Shine. Has to be Shine, yeah.
Shine is definitely my favorite show.
Shine, definitely. I'll never forget.
Just because it meant more to me, because I've been through a lot, and so I felt like my life resonated with the story plot and everything, and I felt like I could give everything to it, so.
I really love performing Shine, and I really love conducting this year. What will your verse be?
I want to say that was incredible. That was super awesome, guys. It sounded awesome. It looked awesome. Emily, Tara, and Alicia, they sounded great. Good job, Tanner and Sarah, for the tempo. Thank you for giving the seniors a great last first show.
I really enjoyed One Small Step. I mean, that I'd have to say that was my favorite, based on like what the show was about. Performance-wise and everything else, I'd have to say was this last year, actually.
If I hadn't stayed in band, I think I would have, you know, probably not met as many people. I probably wouldn't have fun, as much fun as I did in this program.
Like something so extraordinary with a certain group of people that no one else will experience, you kind of create this sort of bond with them.
I feel like when you're part of like a performing, like an instrumental ensemble, you really, like your passion is like enhanced and you really get a sense of how these musical pieces are created and how much work is put into them. So it's like a whole new appreciation for it.
Honestly, it was an extraordinary season and I couldn't have asked for anything else for this season, being that it's my last year.
I think what was special about this year was the fact that in some ways it was solidifying who we've become as an organization. The program has grown in numbers and quality over the last 4 years. We marched 150, but the reality is that we're a 200 member plus strong organization when you count staff and the students and the parents, and everyone has to do their job, and that this, the parent booster dynamic and organization like ours is key to making everything work. Thank you for allowing yourselves to be pushed. It's humbling to be your band director and to get to work with such special students. My verse is to teach students not just how to play instruments and to march and toss flags and, you know, make good productions, but to love the art form that they do. Students at the end of their time in this program would be genuinely in love with music as much as I am.
My verse would be shine in the dark places and lend the world your light, because I feel like you should shine, you shouldn't hide, like everything, you should just be out and make sure everyone sees.
I think, yeah, it's hard to choose, honestly, because they're all so great, I mean, but from Artscapes, we've just been taking it one small step at a time.
Find our verse.
Yeah. Yeah. And lend the world our light. Oh, I'm just kidding. I can't say that.
I think you can cut it. Right there.